H2K Infosys provides world-class online IT training, staffing and software testing solutions to customers worldwide. H2K Infosys supports 100% job-oriented training, hands-on project work, cloud test lab, resume preparation and review, mock interviews, robust syllabus. One-time pay, lifetime access to live classes and videos. H2K Infosys has won the trust of thousands of students worldwide. For free demo class, visit h2kinfosys.com.
Hi, welcome to another video of H2K Infosys. So in this particular video, I'm going to define or rather show you some examples of interface. So for that, I already have the Eclipse open in my system. And in this, I will create a new project called as session number 29. Right click, click on project and create the particular project out here. Session 29, click on the next and click on the finish button. Say no to the perspective. So in this particular source folder, I'm going to create a new package called as interface. And inside this package, I'm going to create a interface first of all. So for creating interface, what we need to do is that highlight the package, right click, go to new option and choose the interface option out here. And I can give the name of the interface as test, because I'm going to show you the rules of interface. And interface is always public. That is the access modifier used for interface. It cannot be private, protected or default interface. Interface needs to be used by third parties. So that is why it is being made public. Click on the finish, and this is how the interface looks like. It's present in a particular package called interface, and this is the interface name. Okay, first of all, if I try to change the access modifier to private, okay, that's going to be a problematic affair out here. Illegal modifier is that you can only use illegal modifier for the interface test. Only public and abstract are permitted. You can have an abstract interface out here. The lowercase, that's fine. Abstract interface means an interface which is not normal. So first let us see what does a normal interface looks like. Okay, now as we have seen, there are certain rules of interface. First of all, the interface will contain, it does not contain the main method. There's no option to actually call the main method also out here. Interface will just declare the rules and regulations, that is the global variables and the methods. So since this is a test interface, I'm going to show you the rules and regulations out here. First, about global variables. They are not called as global variable, they are actually called as constants. Why they are called as constants? Because the value of the variables will be declared and those values cannot be changed in the classes implementing the interface. That is why they are called as constants. So we can use public and default access specifiers for the variables, and that precisely means that we cannot use protected and private. Cannot be used. The constants can be static or non-static. Okay, and the next thing is that can use the final keyword for constants. So I already have the different constants made out here. So I'll just copy it first of all. So this is there in this particular. So these are the constants. We'll discuss each and each be constant out here. Control C and Control V first of all. Now if you look at public is allowed, static is allowed for constant. The data type can be anything. Data type can be string, it can be float, double, etc. So I'm calling this as string, this well str1, and this is the final value. This is nothing but which makes I'm declaring the value of this particular variable, which is public static, and the value is welcome. I cannot change this value of this particular variable. Now public static means it can be basically called in the in a static method, and public means across packages it can be used. Then we can use a public access specifier as we have discussed, and it can be non-static also. That's what I've discussed out here. String too high, this value cannot be changed again in the class implementing this particular interface. And public, it is non-static. Non-static does not have any keyword. Non-static means it has to be called by the object of the class implementing the interface, or the reference variable of the object of the class implementing the interface. So you can have default also. Default doesn't have a keyword. It's a default static string type constant whose value is V, and I cannot change this particular value in the class implementing this particular variable. Similarly, I can have default non-static. Default, this is quick example of default non-static, and default can be also used out here, and non-static can also be used, and the value of this particular variable is ARA. This value cannot be changed in the class implementing it. And how you call a static and a non-static variable or a method, okay, that has to be followed. A static method or a static variable can be called directly inside the class implementing the interface. A non-static method or a non-static variable can have to be called in the object of the class implementing the interface. That has to be followed. Now, protected and private cannot be used for your constants in terms of global variables. And if you see the color of these variables, it is dark blue color. Okay, so if even if it is protected static, okay, I cannot use it, and you will get a syntax error, something like this, illegal modifier. What is allowed is public, static, final are permitted. Similarly, you cannot use protected non-static. I've just shown you for the purpose of explaining you the rules. Similarly, I cannot use the private access modifier or access specifier, what we can call it as. Whether it is static or non-static does not matter, but private is not allowed. So both are showing you a syntax error. It'll show you illegal modifier. The keyword called final is allowed. Final can be static and final can be non-static also. So static, this particular string 9 variable is final, which is static, and the value is this one. So this can be used only in the class, directly in the class implementing the interface. And if the method is basically a static method, this is can call the static global this variable directly. If the method in the class implementing the interface is non-static, it has to be called with a reference with the object of that particular class implementing the interface. Final non-static can be called by obviously the object of the class implementing the interface. These are allowed. So I'm going to put a single line comment out here. As far as methods are concerned, so methods in interface are to be abstract. Are to be abstract. Okay, and it is not compulsory to use compulsory to use the abstract keyword. Okay, if we don't use it, not use it, it would still mean that the method is abstract. Okay, I'll do a block commenting on this, and this is about methods present in the STRA, and abstract method need to be non-static. We cannot have static abstract methods. Now, the usage of the keyword called abstract is not compulsory in interfaces, but if you take a class file and it is an abstract class file, you have to have, you may or may not have the abstract method. That is what we have seen. Now, if we need if we have an abstract method in an abstract class, the abstract method should have the keyword called abstract. Otherwise, the compiler will show you a problem. As far as interface is concerned, the usage of the abstract keyword is not compulsory. If it, even if it is not used, it's fine. Okay. Abstract methods can be only public and default. That's all. It can be only public or default. Let us understand it very clearly. This is another point. Now, interface, apart from abstract method, interface can have concrete methods. Please remember that. I will show an example for that. This also. And concrete methods means method with the body part. But the concrete methods need to be static only. Non-static concrete methods not allowed in interface. Okay. And next point is that concrete methods can be your only public and default, and that precisely gives you a condition that concrete methods control C and control V, concrete methods cannot be protected and private. That is what it means then, and also means that this is an abstract method. It also means that abstract methods cannot be protected and private. Abstract methods can only be public and default. So write down cannot, STRA. So this is the rules that we need to follow. I have already defined it so that we don't waste time. And these are the methods out here. I'll just copy it and explain you first. So these are the methods. If you can see that this is a concrete method because it has the body part. But the concrete method should be public and it should be static. That is what I have defined. Can be public and default. And concrete method needs to be static only. If we create a public method with a non-static, non-static doesn't have any keyword, The return type of concrete method inside the interface can be anything. It is void right now. See, this is a public non-static concrete method, not allowed. So it will show you a problem. Okay, compiler will show you this kind of problem. Abstract methods do not specify a body. That means it is trying to say is that convert it to an abstract method. How? Just put a semicolon. That's all. And the red underline will go. Okay. Similarly, default what's the problem? Public. Okay. So I will comment this first. So this is allowed. I'll copy. Oh, this is coming because this is being duplicated. So this will, I'll, you see, it the concrete method can be also default, and the concrete method, if it is, if a concrete method is default, it has to have a static keyword, and that is what this is. This is default static, what do you call, method, concrete method, and it is allowed. The this is coming because duplicate method T3 is in use. So I'll change this to, for example, 31 at this point of time, and your red underline will go. But you cannot have default non-static concrete method. Default non-static concrete methods cannot be used because only static keywords to be used. Default is allowed, but this is non-static, so this is not allowed. So I'll comment it. Similarly, I've also discussed that you cannot use protected and private. Whether it is static and non-static, it does not matter. The interface will see that, the compiler will see that the interface is protected and private. It will directly show you a syntax problem out here. And it will show the illegal modifier. Duplicate method 31 it is showing. I have not saved the file. Let me save it. You will see out here, illegal modifier. Okay. You cannot use protected keyword as an access specifier for any kind of method that you are declaring inside a interface. Okay, whether it is static and non-static, it does not matter. So I'll call this as 5 purpose. And similarly, this is protected non-static. So protected is not allowed. So what is the case of static and non-static? Doesn't matter. So this is also showing you a problem. So I'll change this to 6. I'll change the, this is 7, this should be 8, this should be 9, this should be 10, this should be 11, this should be 12, this should be 13, this should be 14, this should be 15, 16. Okay, so, and I save this. So if you see a illegal modifier, the protected is not to be accepted by a method defined inside the interface, be it it is static or non-static, whatever it is. Here also illegal modifier. So I'll comment this and comment this also. And let us speak about private. So private access specifier is also not allowed for concrete methods. And this is a concrete method because it has a body part. So whether it is private static or private non-static, not to be allowed inside the methods defined inside the interface. That's a rule. And that is why I define the rule first and then defining with examples of it. And then we have seen that abstract methods can have public and default. Only these two cannot be protected and private. And abstract methods can have the keyword called abstract or may not have it. And third one is that abstract method should be non-static. So out here, I have created a public non-static method. And this method is ending with a terminator sign or a semicolon. That means it's a abstract method by default, even if I have not used the abstract keyword out here. Okay. Now, if you look at this particular thing, it's using the public access specifier. There's no keyword called abstract. Okay. It is not mandatory that you need to have abstract. It is a non-static method. Return type can be anything, and yet it is terminating with a terminator sign. Public is also accepted for the abstract method. Now, yeah, I'm using the keyword called abstract, and it's fine. And then return type can be anything. Test 10. Abstract method can be also default. So this is a example of default abstract method. Even if I have not used the abstract keyword out here, it still becomes a default abstract method which is having a void return type. And the method name is test11. It is ending with a terminator sign. And here this is a default abstract method again, and I've used the abstract keyword out here. So this is why there's a compiler is not showing any problem. But an abstract method cannot be protected or private. So whether you try to create, so abstract methods are non-static, that I am following, but it is protected and private. So this is an abstract method because it is ending with a terminator sign, but the interfaces, the method should only have public and default. This is protected. Being abstract also, this will not be allowed. Illegal modifier, it will show you. This is protected with the abstract keyword being used. That is why it is showing you a compilation problem. Similarly, private cannot be also used for abstract methods. So here I am not using the keyword called abstract, but still it is showing a problem. So I'll comment this. And this is the abstract keyword is used with the private access specifier. This is also not allowed. So I'll comment it. So these are the rules out here. Okay.